أماننا صبح النجاح وابتسامة الفرح فينا بدت.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum to the second edition, or the second hour rather, of Morning Rush. Today being Thursday the 10th of Rabiul Akhir 1437, the English date once again 21st of January 2016. As you have just seen a nasheed there by nasheed artist from South Africa, Lodium to be specific, Brother Muhammed Yaseen. And we are privileged this morning to have Brother Muhammed Yaseen in the flesh, as you would call it, in studio here in ITV Networks. We say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to Brother Muhammed Yaseen.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah for joining us this morning here on Morning Rush.
It's only a pleasure.
Alhamdulillah. Muhammed Yaseen, many viewers might have seen you before, heard you before. Many viewers might have not seen you or heard you before. Do you want to give us a brief history of yourself as a nasheed artist in South Africa?
Yeah, alhamdulillah. You know, for those that actually know who I am, those who don't know who I am, my name is Muhammed Yaseen. I'm 22 years old, from Lodium, Pretoria. Alhamdulillah, you know, I'm still studying my final year of commercial law. I'm Hafiz al-Quran, alhamdulillah. And, you know, the singing started at a very young age. I think it was around 9 years old. But alhamdulillah, it transcended into a career, you know, something that I could never imagine, with the greatness and the kindness of Allah. You know, I started off singing at schools, concerts, at jalsas, at weddings. And alhamdulillah, you know, I've traveled right across the world, Malaysia, Indonesia, Turkey, and alhamdulillah, performed in South Africa.
Alhamdulillah, you've made mention that you're Hafiz, inshallah, by the end of this morning session, we'll be listening to how you recite the Quran.
Allah, so inshallah.
You made mention that you've traveled around many parts of the world.
Yeah.
What are the projects that you have undertaken as a nasheed artist in South Africa, locally or abroad? And what are your current projects, inshallah?
Yeah, you know, we have a lot planned for 2016. 2015 was a good year for us. We started a record label in South Africa. And we tried to, you know, merge with another company overseas, of course. And I released my first debut album, I think, The Scarf, in 2012. And everyone has been asking me since then, you know, when is your next album coming out? We're eagerly waiting. So I had a different approach this time. I said that, you know what, we've tried South Africa, why not go for the world, you know? Alhamdulillah, you know. So that's what we've planned. The 14th of Feb, we've chosen to release the next album, which is called The One. It has been produced in Turkey, it has been produced in Malaysia, it has been produced in Indonesia, it has been all over the world. This project has, I mean, with producers that have worked with world-renowned artists, you know, Maher Zain, Zane Beaker, Cat Stevens, that has also worked with international artists such as Amr Diab in Egypt, you know. So alhamdulillah, you know, that's what we've planned for 2016. 2015, I think we recorded one video in Malaysia and Indonesia with a company that I'm quite well acquainted with called Artifacts, one of their artists, which is the biggest artist in Malaysia. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, you know, I've worked with him, I've produced with him. So 2016, we've started a record label for all nasheed artists in South Africa to fund them, to be able to provide for them, to come onto the platform. Because, I mean, coming onto the platform wasn't easy, especially finding the right producer, finding, you know, we want to produce a product that appeals to all listeners, and it is at very high quality, you know. So 10 years from now, you can still listen to the same thing, it can still appeal to the right crowd and the right generation.
Before we come on to your next album, the one being released next month, let's look at nasheed artists worldwide, and specifically South Africa, as you have made mention, that a bit difficult to get start up as a nasheed artist here in South Africa. What is the role of nasheed artists in South Africa? How difficult is it, and where to for nasheed artists or aspiring nasheed artists?
Well, you know, it all comes down to the fact of which direction you're planning to go. You know, I mean, if you want to go into universal nasheed, if you want to go into a nasheed, traditional nasheed, Arabic nasheed, Urdu nasheed, I mean, the ocean is, it's vast. You can branch out into anything. It's like a career, you know, in that very aspect. But nasheed and Islamic singing has grown tremendously over the past 2 years. I'd say Zane Beaker started it in South Africa, which we all know of, you know, very well known all around the world. You mentioned him in Malaysia, you mentioned him in Indonesia, he's very big. But, you know, it's grown to such an extent that it has become people's career paths. I mean, people have honestly undertaken this as a career, as a livelihood, you know, because I mean, what separates us from a mainstream artist if we want to sing about our religion, if we want to sing about our own aspect of life, you know, why can't we actually be rated at that same level? Because I mean, we put in that amount of effort, we put in that amount of finance. So the nasheed industry has grown, I'd say, by tenfold over the past 2 years, alhamdulillah. And artists are just emerging. But the sad thing is that, you know, artists are finding it difficult. That's why we started with the label. It's called Montal Records. It's based in South Africa. We've pushed it onto Malaysia. We pushed it onto Indonesia. So basically, you come onto the label, we finance you, we help you produce your music videos, we produce a top quality album that is produced all around the world, we take you with us on our tours. Basically, it's to create a consortium of artists that can represent South Africa.
Definitely. So there is a great niche or market out there for specifically Islamic nasheed
artists.
Yeah,
I mean, alhamdulillah, recently I signed up with Artifacts in Malaysia to distribute the album, which is partnered with Sony Music. So Sony Music just don't take any artists. I mean, you know, the modern Justin Bieber, the One Direction. But alhamdulillah, we're looking on that frontier. We want to be on the billboards. We want the Muslim faces advertising for brands. We want them to be able to be able to endorse other companies. You know, we want that opportunity for the youth, because we also have a voice, you know, which is primary objective.
Looking at the digital technology or the digital age, has the digital age has had any impact about the amount of viewers that you have for viewing Islamic nasheeds?
Yeah, of course. I mean, we look at 10 years ago and we look at now, CD albums, solid album CDs were a big thing. Now everything is bought digitally, iTunes, Facebook, Instagram. So digital marketing, digital branding is a vital aspect of everything, creating awareness. We know for a fact anything that hits the market comes from digital, comes from social media. Unfortunately, it is a niche that we have to keep up with. We have no option. But it's something that also helps you connect with the world and get your voice across the world in such a small dimension.
Looking at the picture there, coming soon, 14th of February, your next album. Do you want to take us through your next album, what it consists of, and what inspired you or what motivated you to choose that title?
Well, you know, when I sat with the team in Malaysia, I was currently in Malaysia in December, January, and then prior to that, I traveled with my dad in October, November to sign up for the contract. The album, of course, consists of 9 tracks. We got a vast number of titles on there. We got a new song, which is my personal favorite, which is called Salam. I wrote this as a diverse feel of spoken word to the rest of the world. Then we got Durood, which is a salawat on the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And then we have The Scarf, which we've done completely different. We've got Rabbana, which we've done completely different. We've got Love and Peace, which was a single that was released 1 month ago. We've got a mother song, a song dedicated to our mothers, which are which are such an important part of our lives. We've got other songs, like a song that was done in South Africa called Faith. Like, you know, it speaks about our faith in Allah. It speaks about our faith that we have in Allah. You know, we tend to predict the future. We want to write our own futures, but Allah plans something differently. Definitely. You know, and then of course we got the song The One, which is such a youthful song. If you listen to it, it's unbelievable. It just makes you want to connect with your creator, you know. The reason why I chose the song, the name of the song, is because Allah is the only one. No matter what we do, no matter where we go, you would cry for Allah, you would die for Allah, you would do anything for Allah, you know. And it's such a dynamic, I'd call it a slogan, you know, The One. I mean, like, what are you talking about? You know, all around the world, it's caused up a stir. Like, I was in Malaysia recently, and they're asking me, they're saying, you know, you got Salam. You know, Salam is such a strong word. You know, why are you calling it The One? So I said, okay, when you guys listen to the song, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about.
Hafiz Muhammed Yaseen, we know to make music videos on nasheeds don't happen overnight. Yeah. Take us through the construction of this album. How long did it take you?
Well, we first planned to release the album last year, April, before Ramadan, May, June. But I felt that I wasn't happy. I felt that I needed to do more and put more into the album. So it took me approximately 3 years. When I released The Scarf, I was already working on the second one. So I contacted a few producers. I got a few producers that were actually working with us from Turkey. A brother by the name of Emre from Turkey. My brother Hafiz from Malaysia. Jeremy Karodia from South Africa, of course. And I've worked with Zambika, of course, you know. And then also we've worked with I think 4 or 5 different engineers mixing and mastering the album, you know, because it needs to have that quality, you know. But alhamdulillah, you know, we've established that. That's why we've brought onto this record label that will be doing everything for you. You walk in, it's a 360 route. We find your talent, we discover you, you come on board, we produce your album. As you can see the posters that are out of the album, you know, alhamdulillah, it's been shot in different locations around the country, around the world.
Yeah. So any place for Don and Duck?
Maybe.
20 minutes past 7, inshallah, when we come back, we'll continue our discussion with Hafiz Muhammed Yaseen, Nasheed artist from South Africa, specifically Elodium. Keep watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. You are watching a Morning Rush, the Islamic date being the 10th of Rabiul Akhir 1437, the English date once again, the 21st of January 2016. And we continue our discussion with Hafiz Muhammed Yaseen this morning, a local Nasheed Islamic artist here based in South Africa. And he's singing his way through all the questions that are being posed through to him this morning, alhamdulillah. Muhammed Yaseen, coming back to something that is affecting South Africa very soon, and that is the local government elections or municipal elections. Sure. Your endorsement for this and encouraging the youth, encouraging the Muslims out there to go and vote.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the Muslim population in South Africa, it's ever growing, you know. We're looking at what, plus minus 5 million people over the next few years, inshallah. Mm. And the thing is that we need a say. You know, and what better way to actually get the youth involved? I mean, I know as a Nasheed artist, as a singer, being traveling the world, Muslim countries especially, I mean, you have the Islamic States, Malaysia, Indonesia, which are the biggest Muslim populations in the world, talking of 196 million mm-hmm. people. And it makes such a big difference when there's an Islamic say in the country, especially with regard to your religion, you know. You see it in the culture of the people, you see it in the ways of the people, you see it in the dressing of the people. You even see it in the way that the people speak, you know. And I really don't think that we're very much different, you know. With regard to the whole municipal elections, the reason why I endorse this whole thing is because of the fact that we need to get our youth involved. I always say that when you get an elderly person on the stage, mm-hmm. it has a certain impact. Definitely. But put a young person, the whole world listens. That's how it works, unfortunately, you know. So that's one of the reasons why we're trying to endorse this, and we're trying to create such a major impact. We're trying to get the youth involved. Also from our side, with regard to the social media branding and the development with regard to the municipal elections, we're trying to enforce it. If you go to our websites, you go to Artifacts, you go to Montal Records, you'll see the endorsements that are taking place, you know, because we need the youth to start getting involved. The youth are taking a back step. You know, and by the youth coming back onto a frontier, the world will listen, not only our country. And it makes a big impact, trust me.
You made mention that the youth should take that step forward. Any mm-hmm. advice to all the youth out there, youngsters out there, how they should go and take that step forward, take that leap?
You know, I believe in one thing. I believe Allah has given us the ability to do anything that we want. But unfortunately, some of us actually restrain ourselves. We're afraid of the risk. We are afraid of what actually might succumb from it. But my advice is that, you know, alhamdulillah, being able to travel the world, being able to see many places around the world, do what you love. You know, if you feel you want to become the president, then go up there and try to become the president. I mean, you it's nothing to lose. I mean, yes, it's a failure if you haven't tried, you know. And if you got something in your heart, Allah will question you on the day of Qiyamah that you could make a difference. But why didn't you, you know? And being young and energetic, it makes such a big difference. You know, it makes you want to conquer the world. So I believe one thing, you know, never stop at doing one thing in life. If Allah has given you the ability, if Allah has given you the strength, then go out there, do what you want. If you want to be a speaker, if you want to be a poet, if you want to be a painter, I mean, there's nothing wrong in doing that. Allah has given you the ability, Allah has given you the talent. Go out there, do what you love. Even if you fail 100 times, trust me, I mean, to be able to go to Malaysia, Indonesia, performing, people only see the success that you've done. They haven't seen the 1 million, you know, difficulties that you've tried to, you know, go past and try to pass through, you know. And trust me, when you put your effort and when you put your strength in everything, there's only good that can come from it.
Hafiz Muhammed Yaseen, any advice to upcoming Nasheed artists in South Africa? Any advice to the viewers of ITV out there?
You know, if you want to become a Nasheed artist, go for it. If you want to become a singer, go for it. There's so much of opportunity now. Alhamdulillah, with Allah's help, with Allah's kindness, we that's why we created this company. It wasn't for gain, for anything else, just to give everyone an opportunity, because I know for a fact how difficult it was in terms of finance, in terms of production, in terms of everything. In getting a good product, we really strived really hard, but alhamdulillah, Allah has given us the connection, Allah has given us the ability. You know, so try to reach out to us, try to reach out to other artists. It's the best way. Zain Bika is out there. I know sometimes it's maybe difficult to get in touch with Maher Zain or Sami Yusuf, but we have the know about, we welcome everybody, you know, with open arms. We're not constraining you. If you feel that you want to do something, we look into it. There's always opportunity.
And lastly, details of your upcoming release next month, inshallah.
Yeah, how can get hold of it? I mean, we're on Facebook. Muhammed Yaseen Mohamed, of course, spelled differently. I think my parents are creative. But alhamdulillah, you know, we're on Facebook. You can find us on Instagram, on Twitter. I mean, social media is the quickest way of connecting with people, of people finding out things. Then, of course, we're going to be doing a lot of promo videos on ITV. You can Google my name, you can Google Montal Records. You'll find a lot of the details there. And if there's anything else, then I'm sure that anyone can contact ITV Studios or Channel Islam Stores, where we distribute quite a bit. But most importantly, our social media is very active on a daily basis. We're posting live videos, we're posting videos with international artists. So if you want to get a hold of us, just Facebook us, Instagram us, tweet us, or you can contact you.
Inshallah. Hafiz Muhammed Yaseen, upcoming or established Nasheed Islamic artist here in South Africa. We say Jazakallah for giving us some of your time this
it's
morning.
It's only been a pleasure.
Alhamdulillah. We wish you the best and your team for the future, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Ameen. It is now 27 minutes past 7. You're watching Morning Rush. Stay tuned.